Good afternoon to one and all. Myself, Dr. Arun Vamanrao Dhavale, working as a vice principal in JSPM's Imperial College of Engineering and Research, Wagholi. Today, we are going to discuss why it is necessary to become an engineer. Why engineering? As we know that, what are the basic needs of human being? There are three basic needs of human being. First one is food. Second one is clothes and shelter. So in all these three basic needs of human being, engineering is there. Like for cultivating the crops, for growing the fruits, the knowledge of engineering or the tools and equipments made by the engineers are helpful. Whereas second need of human being, that is clothes, for preparing the clothes, the knowledge of engineering is also required, that is textile engineering is there. Third one is shelter. For shelter, for making the shelter, the knowledge of civil engineering is required. So these are the three basic needs of human being, and those are fulfilled by engineer. That's why engineering is very, very important in our day-to-day life. Now let us assume, imagine the world without engineering. How it will be there if there is no engineering? Let us see this quick review of this picture. If engineers are not there, then our life will become so miserable that we can't imagine. That is, in case of transportation from one place to another place, which is separated by a river or a valley, and without engineering, if we want to construct a bridge, then this may happen. This is second picture, that is calculations, how to make a very huge calculations without engineering, like without computer engineering, without a software engineering. It is very difficult and tiresome job. So here the knowledge of software or computer engineering is helpful to the human being. These are the two just sample pictures I am showing you that why the engineering is important, or without the engineering, how the world will be there. Now, where are the engineers? If you see around our society, the engineers are everywhere. Like, engineers are orbiting in space, astronauts or space engineers, designing a bridge, designing the cars or automobiles or vehicles. The knowledge of mechanical engineering is required. Exploring the ocean engineering is a sub-branch of engineering. The knowledge of ocean engineering is required for exploring the ocean. Developing latest applications and softwares. Designing a smartphone that we are using. Right now, you are witness that during this COVID-19, a smartphone is very helpful and which makes our life so easy during this COVID-19, that is online lectures, online school, online colleges, online or work from home for various industries. Those are dealing through the smartphones and laptops and softwares. Designing the supersonic planes also, the knowledge of engineering is required. So, what is engineer, or what are those persons? The engineers doesn't sit back and watch but they are making the things to they happen. Like engineer must be critical and creative, curious and capable, and ready to handle constantly the changing world. That last line, that is ready to handle constantly changing world. Right now during COVID, you are seeing that there are various inventions made by the engineers. Like one of the example is a ventilators. Ventilator, there are n number of ventilators are invented during these 3 months of lockdown. Let us see this picture. This is a very simple, small picture, but it shows that what is engineer, what engineer can do. Like slogan, samasya kitni bhi bikat ho, aapka kuch nahi bigad sakti agar aap engineer ho to. Like this picture, we know that there is no latch for the door, but by applying the engineering knowledge, you can overcome that difficulty. It is very simple, small example. So if you are engineer, then there is no problem in the world that you can't solve. The engineering portfolios, if you see the portfolios handled by the engineers, they are various. There is no any boundary. And every engineer, it may be mechanical engineer, software engineer, electrical engineer, computer engineer, they are working for a same common goal, like building a sustainable world. What do you mean by sustainable world? That is utilizing the present resources in a such a way that those resources we will keep for our future generation. That is called as a sustainable development. So every engineering branch is working for sustainability of the world. Let us take an example, that is invention of a wheel. Everybody knows that invention of a wheel. It is a small invention in the oldest days. But after the inventing of wheel, there is a transforming in our human being lives. As you can see, you are a witness that small invention of wheel, how our life changes. In construction industry, by constructing various dams, high-rise buildings, bridges. In case of medicine, also the knowledge or the contribution of engineers are very huge, like designing MRI machines, X-ray machines, pacemakers to glucose level monitor. These are the various machineries or the contribution of engineering field in medicine. Next is energy. As we are aware that energy is now the integral part of our human being. Every appliances nowadays are working over the energy. So electrical engineer has a very important and predominant role in our day-to-day life. Apart from these three engineering applications, there are huge engineering applications, like application to automotive industry, application to food processing industry. I hope that you might have been seeing some of the WhatsApp small clips or on the Discovery Channel. That is for food processing industry, how the engineering knowledge or how the various machineries invented by the engineers are used for food processing industries. Then manufacturing, electronics gadgets. Nowadays, this present era is the electronic era, biotechnology, software industry, and whatnot. So engineering knowledge is applicable to each and every facet of our life. So what is the basic ideology of engineers or engineering branch? It is solving the complex issue and making our life simple, safe, and productive. This is the basic ideology of any branch of engineering. Yes, now I hope that you understand why engineering is important in our day-to-day life, how the engineers are contributing towards the society, towards the nation, towards the universe. Then after applying or after getting the engineering degree, what are the various skill sets are there? is which are inculcated in the engineers. First one is creativity. Once you become an engineer, your creativity goes on increasing. You are creating the things, those are helpful to the society, those are helpful to the nation and universe. Analyzing power, your analyzing power tremendously increase. If you compare engineer with another various branches of education, then as an engineer, the analysis power, analyzing power of any problem goes on increasing. Problem solving techniques and looking towards the problem, that view is totally changed once you get or once you become an engineer. Empowerment to the society. Engineers are empowering to the society, that is developing new techniques, developing new employment and contributing towards society, that is called as empowerment to the society. And lastly, resource utilization. This is very, very important. As an engineer, you are getting the knowledge how to utilize the resources. What are those resources? Man, material and machinery. How we can effectively and optimally use so that we can increase the productivity of the nation. We can increase the productivity of the society with the limited resources. During COVID, you might have been seeing that there are so many industries are working with 30% or 40% labor. Why it is so? Because the knowledge of resource utilization we are having, and with that knowledge, we are utilizing and we are running the industry very effectively. So after getting engineering degree, these are some of the skill sets. Those are inculcated in your personality. That is creativity, analyzing, problem solving, empowerment of the society and resource utilization. Let us see this one picture, creativity. In this picture, you can see that there are so many ladders are there and this person wants to look out through this wall. Without the knowledge of engineering, this is the picture. But once you are becoming the engineer, your creativity is changing. Like here, if you don't know how to use them, it will never be enough. Without an engineer, what are the resources are available, it will be never enough. But with the engineering knowledge, with a single ladder, this man can go out to this wall and he or she can see the world beyond that wall. But without the engineering knowledge, this may be the situation. So the creativity is increasing once you study the engineering. Problem solvers. You are become the problem solvers of the society because during the engineering, you are identifying the problems, brainstorming the problems, make some sort of prediction, then revise, then testing the ideas, sharing the result, and again asking the question, what are the various areas of improvement to solve the problem? So you are becoming the problem solvers to the society. As an engineer, you are solving the various problems of the society and a nation. These are two examples, that is creativity and problem solver. Then if you see the history of engineering, it goes beyond 4,500 years ago, like pyramids of Israel or Gaza's pyramids. Then what does it take to be an engineer? What are the various qualities required to become an engineer? For becoming an engineer, you will not require, you should not be a very, very genius to become an engineer. Yes, but something is required to become an engineer. What are those things? Who is going to become an engineer? Yes, you should be curious about various things around you, various things in your society, various problems of your nation and universe. You must be curious. Why it is so? What? How? When? Where? So you must be curious one for thinking. Solve interesting life problems. You must try to solve some of the problems, day-to-day life problems of the society. That must be urged inside you. Some sort of designing and experimentation. Some sort of design you should do, some sort of experimentation you should do, and think how we can improve our result. some sort of knowledge of math and science is required for calculation purpose, and as a person you should have capability to work with the other as a team. So if you are having these five categories or five parameters, then characteristics, then you can easily become engineer. So for becoming engineer, you should not be genius, but you should be curious. You should have solving ability of the problems. You should have some ability to design an experiment. You should have ability to calculate something, and you should have ability to work with a team, because when you are working with a team, then definitely the result is very nice and accurate as work as an individual. So if you are having these characteristics or personalities, or you can say that things, then you can easily become engineer. Then I hope that now you got an idea why engineering is important, or what are the various things is required to become an engineer, or what are the impacts of an engineer on the society and nation. Now there is a big question: which branch of engineering I should choose? Whether I go for computer engineering, whether I go for information technology, civil engineering, electrical engineering, automobile engineering, and what not. There are so many sub branches of engineering are there. So you may get confused where I should go. So no information leads to confusion. Too much also information leads to the confusion. And last point, that is avoid riding on the waves. Right now, if you see the trend of the society, each and every student, just those who get passed in 12th, wants to take admission in computer engineering and IT engineering. That's it. Because nowadays, computer and IT is having a boom. But be careful. Just avoid riding on the wave, because you are taking the admission first year in 2020-21 batch. When that batch comes out in an industry or in a market after 4 years, it may happen that there may be the recession in the computer industry or software industry. So you must avoid riding on the wave. You must think critically. What are the likings of mine? What are the resources available with me? And which branch I can excel? Just avoid riding on the waves. According to your characteristics, according to your thinking, and according to your financial background, you should select a branch. It should not like that nowadays computer engineering is booming, then we must go for computer. No, I am not suggesting you to ride on a wave. So be careful while selecting the branch of engineering. Which branch you like? What are the various resources are available? What are your family background? And then select a suitable branch of engineering. Next question: if you are convinced that I want to become an engineer, if you convince that XYZ branch I want to take admission, the next question arises, that is, which institute of engineering I should select? This is again a big question. Which institute I must select? So how we can select or choose an institute for engineering career? There are again some sort of parameters you must check, you must go through it, because nowadays if you see on online the various websites of various colleges, the websites are so fascinating. They are putting so much good pictures in front of you that you are feeling that this is the one of the institute of my dream where I can pursue my engineering. But no, my friend, you must be very careful while selecting the institute. You must see first parameter, that is placement record. You must check that institute's placement record very, very carefully. What are the various companies visited to that institute for the campus placement? What is the quality of placements? How much students get placed in each and every year throughout various branches of engineering? This is the first parameter you must look while selecting institute. Second one is accreditation. There are various types of accreditations: NAC accreditation, NBA accreditation, ABET. So you must carefully check whether that institute get accredited by NAC with which grade, A grade, B grade, or C grade. Again, NBA accreditation of that particular branch, because NAC is given for institute and NBA is given for a particular branch. You must check whether that branch that you have decided to take admission, that branch is NBA accredited or not. What is the institute inception, when that institute get established? That is also very, very important, because if you take admission in newly instituted institute, then it may happen that you may get a very less experienced faculty members are there. So you must check whether that institute is established 10 years back or 15 years back, then and then only you can say that that institute is established very well. Next is student alumni feedback. Before deciding any institute, you should take some feedback from the alumni or student pass out from that particular institute. What their views regarding that institute, you must consider. Next is facility and ambience. It is not like that you just search on a web of that particular institute and various facilities and photographs are available. No, you must visit personally to that particular XYZ institute and check the ground truth. Ground reality is very, very important. Nowadays, we are living in a virtual world, virtual things, but you must visit physically to that particular institute and check whether whatever may be the photographs or posters and whatever may be the information shown on a website is available ground. It is a, you should check the ground truth reality of that particular institute. So you must visit that institute for checking the facility and ambience of that institute. And yes, quality of teaching staff, that is also important. From website, you can get clear-cut idea of various teaching faculties in that particular department or various faculties available in that particular institute, along with what are the various MOUs are made, what are the various teaching methodologies are adopted by that particular institute, you can easily see. So these are the various parameters you must check whether these parameters are there, and then only you can decide that institute of your dream. So my dear friends, now you are getting clear-cut idea why engineering is required, what are the parameters required to become an engineer, then which branch of engineering we should select, and how we can select the institute of dream. So with all this, I wish you best of luck for my future budding engineers. Thank you very much for patiently listening to me. Thank you, one and all.